Hi, I missed the last episode because of energy vampires.
I'm sure you had fun, and I'm sure we're going to have fun. We return to Yantar. Primarily, this episode is going to be focused on the Dark Valley. But first, I want to meet the Snorks.
The Snork? That can't be what they're called.
That is exactly what they're called, and they're the worst thing ever.
Where's their doopy little head penis? Oh, right, yeah, there. He has one. Well, that answers my question.
The Snorks are one of the freakier mutants you can find. They are very clearly people, whereas the others just have the hints of people, who have been mutated to the point that their gas masks fuse to their heads, and they're actually breathing out of those snouts. Their legs are super strong, which is why they jump at you, and they sound like tigers in this, which is kind of stupid.
A thing to note, I didn't notice it until you kind of, like, zoomed in there. I'm pretty sure that thing that was once an oxygen tube is now some kind of freaky esophagus.
Essentially, yeah, it's now part of their biology.
They sound like tigers. What's this madness?
And also, their spine is exposed.
Ugh, that's goofy. Well, that's not the right word at all.
Yeah, the best thing to do, honestly, with this guy is either waste a billion bullets just trying to kill it in general or shoot it in its dumb head.
I mean, I guess it's supposed to be them growling through that little protrusion. But yeah, it sounds more like a tiger.
Thorn, an AK is not a sniper rifle. Oh my god.
It is if you keep shooting.
Ma'am.
The only reason I came back here is because the professor wanted me to take one of the Snorks' legs. That's their rare drop. I didn't find any through this entire thing, but I did want to go towards this helicopter. Because I can actually get something early here.
Yes, so rare. As we can see, none of these Snorks have legs.
You're not going to take the wannabe M16? That's actually a really good gun.
Yeah, but I don't know that.
Oh boy.
The scientist has an audio log on him. But because I haven't gotten to this point in the game, for one, we don't even know who Ghost is, technically, the audio log doesn't play. It will later once we actually get to that point. But there are some scientific medkits there, at least.
So, when you get the mission, it's gonna be like, find out how where Ghost is. Okay, good, you found out where Ghost is.
Yeah?
And also, as an example, on the way back from out of that area, you can't see the zombies just sort of wandering towards that tunnel.
Oh, you got the modified Deagle.
Blue. Why? Oh, no!
Because it's actually decent night vision. At least a comparison.
Is this the scientist suit?
Yep.
Oh, that's interesting, because in a complete, it's grayscale, not blue.
I'm just leading the dogs towards these guys so they can fight them off for me.
Man, that's so cheap.
Smash him with a guitar. That guy was rocking out, though. He shouldn't have had him in... He should have just kept playing.
Played something festive for when they killed him.
Just like... fucking... As soon as the dogs get close enough, he somehow makes, like, Nightwish symphonies out of that one guitar.
Alright, I've got a hazmat suit. I think it can brave this area. I want to see if I can find some more artifacts.
I can't wait for it to be absolutely not capable.
It's holding up okay.
You're gonna touch like a paperclip and it's just gonna instantly inject all the radiation into you.
Okay, now it's building. Found another meat chunk.
Everything's going cyan!
There goes my kidneys.
No, it's okay, I drained it instantly. And also back to this area where there are these two bandits just sort of hiding out. Because now there's a stash here.
I'm guessing you found that on a dead body.
Wow. Now you can see how far ahead I am in the story that stashes like these are not reliable anymore.
What an amazing loadout. What a great stalker with his leather jacket. Actually, I don't even think that was a leather jacket. I think this is just some shitty poncho that they wear.
Gotta join the tunnel snakes with it. Bada bing, bada in.
Tunnel snakes rule!
What's tunnel snakes from again? The Outsiders, right? No, those
no,
are
no, Fallout 3.
Right.
The only memorable thing of that game to me.
That's a more appropriate reference than The Outsiders, the shitty book that everyone read in middle school.
I actually don't remember that book.
Now this is the entrance of the Dark Valley, and it is heavily irradiated. Not as badly as on top of the garbage, but hey. Oh no, get back down here.
Another fucking battery, what?
Yeah, I've got like three now.
Cool, one more and we could power like a flashlight or something.
And I'm just checking to see if there's something else over there. There is not.
I don't think any kid is going to recognize that reference. Who knows what the hell a D battery is anymore now that we have rechargeable lithium ion batteries.
Well, since I live in Florida and we just went through a hurricane, kids better fucking know what a D battery is now.
Is being taken to the abandoned factory. That's all I know, I swear.
Okay, Scum. You can.
Yeah, he definitely sounds like he's dying.
Just don't let me see you ever again.
Oh, hello. Could you please provide me with some gauze? I'm currently losing my stomach.
Follow me. I know a good place for an ambush. I'll thank you for your help. Adieu.
If it's a good place for an ambush, it's probably well known, thus a bad place for an ambush.
Are you gonna do it, Thorn?
Well, if he's not going in.
Good.
No. No.
You can't help him, you can't befriend him, and he's just generally bad, so why the hell leave him?
Not Mr. Calmly Bleeding.
I do that too, just because I'm a greedy fuck.
So, Bullet there wants me to follow him. I forget to follow him.
Oh, good.
This is actually a side mission. I'm supposed to help him free one of his friends from a couple of bandits. Because I forget to do that, I fail the mission, and then they're kind of mad at me. I will do it correctly in 7-2.
Not great. Cliffhanger for the sequel.
Oh my god, we're actually using all the batteries. I don't know why this amuses me so.
Ah, yes.
Doesn't do shit to me.
As per usual, Thorne's like, ooh, yes, shock me, oh yeah.
Yeah, sorry, Bullet, I'm just gonna put these batteries up my butt and get this artifact. I call it the Shining Dragon.
Well, I also found a soul, which is an even better meat chunk. And I'm gonna wear two more meat chunks, I guess.
So you just staple two stakes to your biceps like, I can never be killed!
Now this little pond here is also heavily irradiated.
Just jump in it!
But I want to see if there's stuff here.
Is it irradiated or just toxic?
Technically both.
Yeah.
There's a stash. Just inside that log.
We just found some 15-year-old's booze stash. What are we doing? What are we doing from our life stealing a child's booze stash?
What the hell, man? I've been skeeved by the man.
He's probably dead.
And been skeeved by the man. While dead.
That's an artifact. Another sparkler. And that is a flash.
We already have those, don't we?
Yep, but it's good to have multiples sometimes. Especially since they are the endurance ones.
It's good to pick up 20,000 rubles for no discernible reason.
That's why I'm rich right now.
You leave the zone, it's like $20. I'm rich!
I worked very hard for this burger. Damn it. Soon as I got there, too.
You didn't free the Dutyer.
Luckily, he survived, though. When I did it correctly, it took a couple of takes, but in at least the first take, he died.
Get lost.
Fuck off. Okay, trade with me.
I love how the only dialogue option was bye.
Get out of here, Stalker. I said, come in, don't just stand there. Just buy his lunch, what the fuck?
Yeah, whatever. He came from behind that bus, up in the distance. And further behind that bus is where we're headed. There's a large bandit hideout, and we need to infiltrate it.
Lorne?
Hmm?
I think large bandit hideout is way better.
Me too.
I'm sorry, but...
What did I say?
You said large bandit, and I'm just like...
It was a flub.
It was a flub, but it was the best flub, because now we're taking on the lard bandits. It's like the sticky bandits, it's like somehow even worse. Now that's a reference no one's gonna get.
Okay, do I need to draw attention to my fucking stutter? Because I'm not proud of that, and the reason I repeat shit is so I can edit it out. So fucking thanks, High Wing. I have to leave it in now.
I mean, we could retake if you want, I'm sorry.
I don't give a shit. Watch this. Guy's just wandering down a ladder.
Man.
While I shoot him with my nut sniper. This is for you, Wang. Go fuck yourself.
Ma'am, please calm down. Your AK is not a cup holder.
I honestly thought he was falling down like he got stuck in the rungs.
I wanted to make that joke earlier, but I got my chance.
Where the hell is he? Oh, there he is.
What?
Keeps using the gate as cover.
Master of stealth.
Now, there's actually another dutier stuck around here. If you go around the outside, you can find him. I think I talked to him. Yeah, there he is.
How did those feet get there?
Help me out. I'm gonna get crushed real soon.
Interesting choice of words.
That's how they execute people in this land.
If you had saved that first dutier, there would be a second mission specifically to save that guy. You can still save him, though. What I'm going to do, I'm looking a little around the perimeter here for some extra stuff. This building is going to be difficult. I'm going to climb around the outside. There's a dude who's stuck in here, injured. And if I can rescue him, he'll give me some information. If I can climb the damn ladder.
Oh yeah, this thing I never knew about until quite recently.
Alright, let's... None of my weapons are good for long distance.
I've noticed.
Yeah, at this point of the game, they really don't give you anything good. Like, your best option is the AK.
Well, I managed to hit him at least. Not in any good spot. Hold on a damn minute. Did that bullet hit like 100 feet above him?
Yeah,
bullet spread in this game is kind of wacky.
So let's help this dude out. Oh, well, never mind. Oh good, a bloodsucker. And he died anyway.
He was so happy about it too, like, woohoo!
Woohoo, I'm dead.
Oh man. Getting bad, and I'm getting shot at.
God damn. Yeah, let's try this again, it went great last time. Body block him.
How does a double-barreled shotgun jam? That doesn't make any sense!
Because Stalker, Highway.
Also, guys have a tendency to wander in while I'm trying to deal with this shit. And a dog.
Hey, Pupper? Oh, bye, Pupper.
Oh, there's the Bloodsucker.
Sorry I'm late. I was getting Starbucks.
I can't run away from him when he hits me.
Hi.
Son of a bitch.
He already dies alone.
You're going through so much trouble to save this one probably unimportant view.
Welcome to the death cyclone that is Stalker.
There we go.
The amusing thing about all this is that at random times the game just makes a tracer shot to you so you know where your stuff, and you can see, like, at several points, bullets just bounce the fuck off enemies. When you were shooting that bloodsucker in the back, it just glanced off his spine.
There we go. Mr. Muskrat. And he gives me some juicy details. Apparently there's a Stalker camp down to the south of this area, and they're selling a Gauss rifle for cheap. I'ma get that.
No fucking way. No fucking way.
Fuck off!
You're never gonna leave this building! Never mind, you left the building.
I left the building, and I left him to die. Now that I have the information, I don't need to save him.
Yeah, we acquired that in our 12th version of reality.
So here's the Stalker camp. It's another one of those abandoned farms. Excuse me.
Hello. Do any of you have claws? If so, stay where you are.
That's a pretty nice stash, and I think I'm encumbered now. Because of all the food I don't eat, or need. It didn't take long, but I'm already beyond the point of really needing to stock up.
You just raided some dude's stag party is what you did.
So he just said the lawless are hiding in the building. So I think we can see where this is gonna go. Yeah, I want an awesome gun. So just 800 rubles. Give me that shit. Oh, he has to go in and get it. Go ahead, Mishka Fireman. Do it. Go. Thank you.
Fireman. Okay, fire.
What's he doing? Hey, guys.
Listen to me carefully, sucker. Have you heard the story of Robin Hood? Well, your money went to feed the poor. Forget about it. Try sticking your nose here again, and you'll be crawling back to your mommy.
Did he just run away to threaten you?
Yeah, that's gonna work for me.
Hey, man, I need something. Hold on, give me a minute. Fuck off!
Wow, that dude's an idiot.
Let's kill everyone in the building.
All for probably 80 cents?
Let's see how many I can kill without them noticing, at least.
What's going on over here?
Who killed him? I don't understand! What is happening? Oh, Stalker AI. I love you. What a good AI.
The guys are running around pretty hilariously, too.
Reminds me of this one time I was playing Hotline Miami on stream, and I got the upgrade where you could kill people with doors. And there were these, there's this group of like four people walking around the perimeter of a room. So I just like opened the door as each of them walked in, or walked by the door. I was like, bam, dead, bam, dead. They didn't give a shit. These people were smacking smack with doors, like second by second. It's like, okay, better keep walking.
Well, you know what they say, Jacob. The doorman should wear a suit.
Well, yeah, I was actually wearing a horse mask.
Can't even get that right.
Come on.
Where is he? Where'd he go? I can't see him. He must be really short.
Did you see him?
Okay.
Did you see him?
What?
Did you still see him? Have you seen him yet? Oh, there you are.
What an entirely appropriate ending.
Oh my god.
Oh, my stomach.
On the plus side, I don't think that was the guy who robbed us. But one of the guys has a silenced viper, and it's actually really powerful and really accurate.
This is a good episode.
Just call this the tornado of death.
So, unsurprisingly, no, there's no Gauss rifle here.
Oh. Fucking lies.
I wonder why.
Ugh, is it in here? No.
Hope the poor feel well fed now.
I think the only way that would have been more appropriate is actually they gave you the Gauss rifle but no ammo, so you feel like a fucking moron lugging this 20-pound gun around.
That would also be funny. I think. But let's actually infiltrate the bandit hideout, and not the bandit.
Where's the stairs to get into these places?
We don't need no stairs. We're going in the sewer.
What stairs are you talking about, man? This is post-apocalyptic, fuck, I don't remember the actual location.
Ukraine!
Ukraine? This is post-apocalyptic Ukraine, there's no stairs here, man. I'm surprised there's functioning ladders.
Just gotta pull yourself up.
I'm a little confused here. It's because the stash is inside that tunnel. That tunnel is actually our exit. I should be looking for the entrance.
That's a great idea for a band. Post-apocalyptica. Just a rock band that uses nothing but broken cellos.
What are they shooting at?
I don't know. Could be at me.
They're behind the wall, though. They can't possibly...
There might be another dutier in there. Not the guy stuck in that little cell, but another dude, because you can find a duty corpse in just this big hole. So maybe that was them actually killing him.
Well, this sewer system would make my future playthrough as much of a headache, because I don't use this at all. I didn't even know this exists. I just walked in the front fucking door.
I did that too. Borov is the leader of the bandits, so he's not gonna just hand it over. I kinda ran around in a circle for a little bit. This is actually a side path with some well-hidden ammo. Ammo for what? I'm not quite sure.
If it's Gauss rifle ammo, I'm going to be so happy.
You know, one thing that I can really appreciate about this time in the game is that the storm that's been going on for a while is actually really, like, slightly scary. I like it. It's good atmosphere.
Yeah.
You're too heavily loaded to continue. Please fire bullets to reduce your weight.
Yeah, just picked up AK bullets.
That's one of the smart things that Fallout did, where ammo and money don't weigh anything. Because it just sucks when it does.
It's an immersive FPS.
It makes sense, but it really does bog down a lot of things. Like, you want to feel prepared and don't want to be unloaded, but then you also realize, well, I can't fucking carry anything anymore.
It's another dude in another tower.
Like I said, they took out shit.
Let's see if I could sneak in there without him seeing me. I think he shot at me, but he didn't hit me. Oh, another droplet.
Is that a... it looked like a leech just leeching around.
Yeah.
I was gonna say that until that picking of that thing was just like, oh no, I can't move anymore.
That's what I do when I pick up an artifact and I'm out of carry weight. Just eat some lunch. Ooh, right in the nuts. Can't figure out where it's coming from.
Probably a gun. I'm just saying.
I said where.
Oh. Oh god, I thought someone was snoring. That's not that.
Oh. The guards. Yeah, the durability on this AK is getting kind of low, so it's jamming a lot more.
Oh my god, that movement was in fast motion.
Oh wow, I actually managed to save the dutier. Usually he's dead.
Yeah.
And he's down there.
The dude has like a half-life of 5 seconds.
And of course I save him on the take where I didn't save the first one. And naturally there's a lot of artifacts around here, mostly fireballs. And I think there's more in one of these crates, too.
Fireball is anti-radiation, right?
Yeah.
I think they want you to gear up for future endeavors, that's why.
That stash right there I actually ended up using as my own stash, just putting things in there. I never came back for it, though, so it was kind of pointless.
What did you ditch?
Just a lot of the excess artifacts.
Ah. Man, one stalker's just gonna open that. I'm rich.
Oh, nope, he's dead. He's still standing, though. I really should have used this Viper more often. It's remarkably good.
It uses, like, the baby bullets, so kind of, I would imagine at this point it also just tapers off really quickly.
Oh, he got stuck in the floor.
That guy looks comfortable.
Yeah. Here we are. I think I should have gone down, and then I could actually save the dutier faster. But it takes me a while to find him. No! Oh, hello.
Wow, that dude got it bad. Just from the torso up, bullet.
Where'd he go? What? Ah,
Volivon!
Behind the spools.
Of course.
The enemy AI has a very uncanny ability to perfectly match its environment.
I know.
It almost amazes me.
Like, damn, I could not see a single bit of him.
Because he took this shape entirely.
This was the one spool man. It's like Spoon Man. Spoon Man? Yeah, that's the name of the song.
Ah! He missed you entirely.
Yeah. Every bullet went an inch around me.
It's part of his circus act. It's like throwing knives, but with a gun. Dude, that'd be kind of cool.
Let's go down now. Aha. Where do they go?
Are you kidding?
They just wander off.
It's almost amazing how just cunning and idiotic the AI is.
Right.
Simultaneously. They're all just squatting down and waiting for me. None of them are coming after me, but they all know I'm here. And luckily, yeah, the Viper uses bullets that these guys are using for their pistols. So most of them seem to have ammo. Fred!
Man, I must have not messed up my weapon at all when I last played this, because I don't remember seeing weapon jam at all last time I played this.
It might be another thing they took out, or at least they reduced with Stalker Complete.
Oh yeah. Which honestly is for the better. Because gun jam just seems so unfair.
Yeah, I think there are guys on both sides of me.
You're fired.
He wound it up too. It wasn't like bleh. It was like bleh.
Boing. Want to see if there's something up there. See, look how good this Viper is.
Sorry, I don't know why that boing was hilarious.
And of course, there's another guy hidden behind that desk. There he is.
I mean, a desk makes sense. Humans are very desk-shaped.
I am.
I didn't mean to pick the gun up. It's a little annoying you can't unload them when you're in a trade screen.
Yeah.
There's Borov.
Shoot him.
Oh. There went Borov.
Hey, did it.
I wonder what went through his mind.
That's a nice cooch. Couch.
Thank you for correcting.
Okay, Jacob? Cooch means something entirely different. Use your words.
It took me like a full second to realize that after I said it. I was trying to speak Jacob, but Jacob can sometimes have some weird meanings in other languages.
Like, bleh.
Bleh.
So this is kind of cool. All of these lockers are locked, but you can take items right out of them anyway.
Oh, well, how?
The game just doesn't care about walls, I guess. And that's a pretty nice stash. There's some armor-piercing AK bullets and grenades for the grenade launcher.
I just imagine you just took like a wire hanger, just kind of fished it into the locker and pulled out like a huge-ass box of ammo that you threw away, mind you! You threw away really good ammunition, Thorn! Oh my god!
Ah.
That I was never gonna use.
Let him play the game!
So mad. You know how rare those white bullets are? My god!
I'm never gonna use the gun that they go to.
There's like five different guns they use in me. Oh well, it's fine. I'm just visibly upset because I like the gun line from those for those bullets.
What gun do they go to?
I can never remember, but it goes in the Enfield, the fake M16, which name I can never remember, the SIG-9, the G36, and something I like to affectionately call fish gun.
Here's how we get to the dude here. Looking around just in case, but there never seems to be guys down here.
Hey, Stalker, help me out. Open the door to this damn cell. The controls are on the wall.
No.
That, you cannot tell that that's a panel.
Yeah.
I thought it was a lamp.
Shaggy.
Shaggy.
Shaggy circle. Like Zoink's scope.
Thanks for helping me, but I heard you didn't help my brother with the ambush. Fuck off.
If you save him first, he tells you information you already know anyway. So I'm just gonna get some money off of him.
Don't you have to, like... Hmm. Aren't you supposed to, like, give that guy a gun or something?
No, he has them.
Huh.
And there's a stash right through that grate.
Oh, what?
Pretty nice stash. And now he's gonna wander upstairs and fight any bandits he comes across. If you'll let me up.
No, this is good. This is fine. This is the stalker experience. The AI being absolutely idiotic.
Oh, that's him. Okay.
Oh, I would have laughed if you just blew him away in one shot.
My room!
That was fun.
Hell, are any of you still alive?
Now, the door I open leads to... what do you call this? Paradise?
Yeah.
Shitload of vodka, shitload of explosives, which, again, in Stalker Complete, you can pick those gas tanks up. There's also a ton of guns, some of them with ammo in them. There's a lot of ammo just in general. A lot of healing items, and some more grenades for your grenade attachment.
Now, here's the tragic part. You will never have enough carrying capacity for all that vodka.
Yeah. Not unless you just outright mod in greater carry capacity.
No.
I think it's like 40 bottles of vodka.
I need it.
This is the worst thing.
Yeah. Now, there was a regular grenade in there. I could have carried that.
I really wish you picked up that bandana and it says you are too overencumbered to continue.
I think I had to drop some more fireballs to carry anything.
Like, this really is a kleptomaniac's worst nightmare. All this stuff to take, and yet you could only carry so much. Half of your carrying capacity in general is just your gun and armor.
Yeah. But I've got everything I need. Let's escape through the tunnel. That is not a person.
I kind of wish this game did something, like, cheeky in a way and just put some vaguely realistic human graffiti on a wall. That way players would see it and try and shoot it. But then they realize it's just graffiti and they'll be like, well, fuck this. You know, kind of like with old Counter-Strike.
Smart one dude. This place is safe.
I mean, there's only one way you could have possibly came from, and he was ready to go. His defenses were bulletproof.
But not his body.
No. Next one.
Yeah, I know.
Let's find the entrance to the lab. It's not in here. Moving on down the hall. Is it in here? No. There is a hog of salami? What was that?
Of course it's salami. Or at least sausage.
A whole hog of salami. What a diaphic!
It was like a combination of a hunk and a log. So it's like...
I like the idea. Butcher, can I have a whole hogshead of salami?
We're fucking sure, man. I'll season it before I debone it for you.
God, this is annoying. If you press the left button at the top there, it zooms out the entire map. And then you need to wait for it to stop zooming before you can zoom in on yourself again. So on my way out, immediately, this little loner outpost gets attacked by more bandits. Funny thing is, this was a mission I could have taken from the barkeep, but I decided not to, and it's like, no, you're gonna do it anyway.
Yeah, this place is always getting fucking attacked. It's terrible. Just gonna chill here, because if you move one inch, you're gonna get a bullet in the brain.
That... He is in the wall. He is on the other side of the wall, but he's still shooting through.
Yep.
The fact that there are so many large open spaces with enemies that are so far away, and they never give you a sniper rifle, absolutely infuriates me.
Mm-hmm.
At least not for a long time.
Yeah, the earliest you could get it, I think, is in the area... Have we been... Well, we're in Dark Valley, so we should... Yeah, you mentioned Barkeeper, so yeah. There's an area past the bar where you could get a sniper rifle. That's the earliest place you could get a sniper rifle, and that's a good 60-70% through the game.
What the fuck?
Yeah. It's not great.
Boing. Well, I hauled my fat ass over here. I'm full of shit. You have to wait for Barkeep to turn around and walk towards you before you can talk to him.
I don't know if I mentioned it before, but I believe, and I say believe, that the footage going on at the bar's TV behind him is alpha footage for Stalker.
It does look like it.
A gif of it, specifically.
At 10 frames a second.
Let me tell you, if there is one thing I miss from before the apocalypse, it's cable.
Yeah. Oh, man. That would suck.
I have been watching this one GIF for the last 20 years.
It was the only thing I saved on my phone. It's terrible.
Just clearing out some of my personal stash. I'm bringing along the RPG. Just in case. Because it might be quite useful in the lab next time.
Oh.
Does it also tend to fire diagonally from where you're aiming?
Yes.
Not too badly, but you can still miss, yeah.
There's no fucking thing as perfect accuracy in this game.
You fire it, you don't see it for a minute, you're like, where'd it go? And it went straight up.
You ever play Valkyria Chronicles, Jacob?
No.
It's a game which is basically World War II, but with anime, and it's kind of like a mix of XCOM meets, like, third-person shooters. And in that game, it uses, like, third-person shooter combat. You take your turns going around, running, shooting. But even then, it's still affected by stats, so you can have a sniper with 99% accuracy, laser-focused accuracy, and they'll still miss their target by a hair's width, and it's so fucking infuriating.
Yeah, man, that's 99%. If you were gonna hit, it'd be 100%.
Just kind of like with Stalker, feels disingenuous when you have, like, a crosshair, and then the bullet goes, like, 90 degrees off into the sky.
Well, in a first-person shooter, you're in complete control of your character. Like, if you're aiming somewhere, that's exactly where you're going to be aiming. In a game like that, where you're controlling, like, units, like, there's always the chance that the unit themselves fuck up because you're not in complete control of them.
Yeah, I guess.
In a first-person shooter, it's like, I'm going to aim right here. Yes, there's bullet spread. Yes, there's bullet drop. But I can rest kind of assured that the first shot will go generally there.
Except in Stalker.
Ah!
Reminder, this is a good game.
It is a good game, it just has so many problems. It was gonna get a sequel, but then it didn't. Stalker 2 was gonna be a thing.
It was until it didn't.
I don't know what happened, but Stalker 2 was announced and then promptly dropped.
Why they call it Stalker 2? Did they just forget about Call of Pripyat?
I think the whole Stalker series, like Chernobyl, Sky, and Pripyat were the contained story of one instance in the zone. I think Stalker 2 was going to be a new story.
It could also be like Grand Theft Auto, where there were five games between Grand Theft Auto 3 and 4.
Were there?
Vice City, San Andreas, Liberty City Stories, and Vice City Stories 4.
Oh, I don't know. I just never considered like the X City Stories as like a complete thing, but maybe they are.
Well, they are full Grand Theft Auto games, from what I can understand.
Hmm. But yeah, I think Stalker 2 is just going to be either, like, an evolution of the results of Chernobyl and Pripyat, but then it just kind of didn't. One of the great mysteries of the zone, why it ate its own sequel.
Such is game development in the zone.
The development zone. Beep, beep, beep! I don't know the theme song to X-Files. I mean, Twilight Zone.
Two totally different TV shows.
There might be a number of things you don't know, Jacob.
There are. See you guys next time.
Boing.